In this video, I will show you how to use SnapGene to simulate a simple Gibson Assembly cloning experiment. Gibson Assembly is a popular cloning technique used to insert a single fragment or multiple fragments into a vector without the need to use restriction enzymes. In this tutorial, I will simulate a simple experiment where a single fragment is inserted into a vector using Gibson Assembly. Within SnapGene, I have a file containing the Lenti-Cas9 EGFP plasmid open. I want to replace the EGFP reporter, as indicated by this green arrow feature, with a different reporter I have in a different plasmid. In a separate file, I have the sequence containing the P-Turbo YFP PRL plasmid, which contains the Turbo YFP reporter I am interested in. And this is indicated by the yellow arrow feature. It is this feature that I want to replace the EGFP reporter with in my first plasmid. To simulate Gibson assembly, I will switch back to the first file containing the Lenti-Cas9 plasmid, and I will go to Actions, Gibson Assembly, and then Insert Fragment. In this first tab called Vector, I need to select the file containing my vector. I can do this by using the drop-down menu to the right. Since the Lenti-Cas9 EGFP file was active when I chose the Gibson assembly command, this file is automatically selected as my vector. Next, I will select an area within the vector that will be the site of insertion or will be replaced. In this case, I want to replace the EGFP reporter, so I will select this feature. If you need more precision when selecting a region of insertion, you can switch to the sequence view. I will now go to the second tab called Fragment. Then I will use the drop-down menu to the right to select the file containing my fragment of interest. In this case, the file is the Turbo YFP reporter. Next, I will select the fragment that I want to insert. This will be the Turbo YFP feature. So I will select this. Another important point to consider at this point is the orientation of the fragment. Fortunately, the fragment I am inserting and the region I am replacing are in the same orientation. However, if this wasn't the case, I can simply change the orientation of my fragment by using the arrows to the right. I will now switch to the final tab called Product and select the Choose Overlapping PCR Primers button to enable SnapGene to design the most suitable primers for this reaction. In the first option, you can specify the melting temperature or TM for the PCR primers. By default, this is set to 60 degrees Celsius, and I will leave this unchanged. The PCR primers will be designed to contain overlapping ends to permit Gibson assembly. Depending on your Gibson assembly protocol, you can select to have overlapping bases of a certain length, such as 40 bases, or you can specify a range of overlapping bases, such as 15 to 25 bases. Since I will be using the Gibson Assembly cloning kit from New England Biolabs, I will select the latter option. This is because the manufacturer recommends using overlaps between 15 and 25 bases with a target melting temperature of approximately 50 degrees Celsius for the overlaps. I will now select Choose Primers to design the primers with these settings. In the schematic at the bottom, you will see a summary of the simulation. The fragment is coloured in red, which overlaps with the vector coloured in black. In this example, the overlapping regions are 15 and 24 base pairs. In the map view, I can preview the final product. The fragment insert, in this case the Turbo YFP feature, has been inserted into the vector in place of the EGFP feature. To finish the simulation, I will call the file Lenti-Cas9 Turbo YFP and click Assemble. In the map view, you can see the newly designed primers in purple, and these primer sequences can be found in the Primers tab. I can also select to show history colours, which will highlight in red where the assembly occurred. If I switch to the sequence view and scroll down to the new fragment, I can see the vector and fragment primers and their overlaps. Finally, going to the history view will show a schematic workflow of the Gibson assembly that has just been performed. And that brings me to the end of this tutorial. In this tutorial, you have learned how to use SnapGene to simulate a Gibson assembly cloning procedure with a single fragment. For more information about simulating other cloning techniques in SnapGene, check out the tutorials on the SnapGene website.